गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम गौरव गुप्ता एज योर मैथमेटिक्स टीचर। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस आवर चैप्टर वन एक्सरसाइज 1.4। बिफोर टू स्टार्ट द एक्सरसाइज फर्स्टली वी हैव टू डू इट्स एग्जाम्पल। सो आई विल टेक ईच एंड एवरी क्वेश्चन इन डिटेल, देन वी विल प्रोसीड टू आवर एक्सरसाइज। सो इन दिस फर्स्टली वी हैव टू स्ट्रॉन्ग आवर बेसिक्स how we do the exercise. So this is our first video, so I request to everyone, please listen to me carefully. And again I request, there is no need to continuously note down the matters of whatever I write, because I have given time to you to take as a screenshot or making a note. So don't waste our time. Let's come on our first topic. Our first topic is representing real number on a number lines. It means if we have any number, suppose 1, 2, 3, and we have to represent it on a number line. And it's very easy. We take or we make graph as well as number lines in class 8, in class 7, and so on. But now the problem is we have not to represent only one, we have to represent real number. Real number may be in terms of fraction also, like 1.2, 1.3, 1, 2 and so on, maybe n. So how we can represent a number on a number line? So we have to follow step to step rules, and we can easily locate our number on a, or we can locate our real number on a number line axis. Then what we have to do and how we represent this? So let's look. Now I take an example to represent 5.37 on a number line. Again I repeat, I have to represent a number 5.37 on a number line. So keep in mind, we take firstly our first digit, then match to second digit, then match to third digit. It means we not directly to represent the whole number at a time. We have to do step by step. We have to firstly locate our first digit. Then we have to search our second digit. Then we have to search our third digit. In this manner, we can locate any decimal digit, whatever the decimal digit is, 2, 3, 4, and so on. It's quite easy. Please look. First digit is our 5. Then firstly we have to locate a number 5. So make a rough sketch or make a rough scale. Suppose I make a scale. This is your scale. And everyone know this is your 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, up to 15. So you can draw or a line and mention 1 to 15. This is basically represent a scale. So it is not necessary to draw a scale of 15 centimeter. You can take any length, but keep in mind that scale must include your first digit. So firstly you locate your first digit. This is our first digit. So make a circle, our first digit, and we have to take its next digit. Your next digit is 6. Now we get a boundary that our number is start from 5 and in between to 5 and 6, not greater than 6. Now this is your first step. The next step is to take or to divide your interval. This is 5, 6. This is your interval. And we have to divide this interval into 10 equal parts. I again repeat. You get an interval. In this we have got the interval 5 to 6. So you have to divide this interval into 10 equal parts. So I divide this interval in 10 equal parts. So you make a rough line. maker of line, and mention here 5, and take 10 equal parts. Like this is your 5. Now next digit is our 5 prime. It means we have to start. This is your 5. This one is your first part, and this one will be 5.1. Now second part is 5.2. Third part is 5.3. 5.4. And you have take 5.5 as a small big line. This is your 5.6, 5.7, 5.8, 5.9, and this one is your 6. So basically what we have to do here, we divide the interval into 10 equal parts. But you can see that we nothing do, we are taking a zoom process. Mostly we have take video, and if we zoom that, it will be expand. So here we do same step, we expand it into 10 equal parts. Now you have to search your next digit. Here our first digit is 5, we search. Next digit is 3. Now you have to locate your second digit. Where is second digit? So whenever you search your second digit, together with your first digit also, not the lone digits. So in this we have take both the digits. Here 5.3, where you will go? 5.3 is this. So make a circle 5.3 and take its next interval 5.4. Now again repeat the process, divide it, this interval, into 10 equal parts. So we again divide the intervals in 10 equal parts. This one is your 5.3, and this one is your last 5.4. We have to divide it into 10 equal parts. So this one is your first digit 5.3, and we can add 0 at the right hand side because it doesn't affect the value. So this one is your 5.30. So this means 5.31. This one is your 5.32, 5.33, 5.34, 5.35, 5.36, 5.37, 5.38, 5.39, and 5.4, that your last digit. So what we have to locate? We have to locate 5.37, and where it is? 5.37, this is you. So please mark this. This is your real, this is your number line. And this will be your number. So in this case, we represent 5.37 on the number line. Again, I repeat the question. Please listen to me carefully. Now our question is to represent 5.37. 5.37 basically is real number. The question is representing real number. So 5.37 is your real number, and we have to represent it on the number line. So what type of process you have to follow? Firstly, you have to check your first digit. Here our first digit is 5. Firstly, you have to draw a number line. Here I draw a number line. Which is this? This is simply your number line axis. This is your simple number line axis. And naming this 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. So our first digit is 5. So you have to focus on our first digit 5. First digit is 5. Make a circle and take its next value. Here it is next value 6. We get an interval. Now if we zoom this, it means we divide this interval into 10 equal parts so that we can locate, because our number is this indicate that our number is greater than 5 but less than 6. Where it is? That's why we have to zoom this. And for zoom purpose, we divide this into 10 equal parts. So here is 5, second last value is 6, and we divide this into 10 equal parts. So if 5 our first digit, and we can also write 5 as 5.0. We can write as 5 as 5.0. So we write here 5.0. So next one is 5.1, next one is 5.2, 5.3, and so on. Last number is 6. Now we get our first two digits, 5.3 here. So focus on first number is 5.37. Make a circle. Take next one, which one is 5.4. We get an interval. So again divide this interval into 10 equal parts. Now our first value is 5.3 and last value is 5.4, and we can write 0 at the end because it doesn't change its value. That's why I write 5.30. The next value is 5.31, next one is 5.32, 5.34, up to 5.39, up to 5.40. That's your last value. Now we have to look at 5.37. Where it is? Here it is. 5.37. Please dark this. So this one is your locate of real number 5.37 on number 9 axis. I hope this will be clear to you. So I will take some more examples. Firstly, please make a note. So I am going to take another one example. Our question is to locate a real number 4.26 bar, and you know what's the indication of bar. Bar indicates that your number is non-terminating and repeating. So we can write this number as 4.262626. Up to and so on. So this number is your basically real number, non-terminating but repeating number, and we have to represent it on a number lines. As we already discussed, we have to follow the all the steps are same. So we take one by one each step. So please make a note first. Firstly, we have to draw a number line. We draw a number line. This is our first number line, and naming this is your 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and so on. Because we have to take 4, because our number is starting from 4, it means the number is greater than 4 but less than 5. So there is no need for further writes. We have to take an interval 4 and 5. There is no need before that and after that number. So our first number is starting from 4. Your first digit is 4. So make a circle and we take its next value also. So this will indicate our number is greater than 4 but less than 5. Now we have to divide this into 10 equal intervals. So and again make a number line. This is your number line axis. Number line axis. Our first value is 4 and we can take as 4.0. Our next value is 5.0. What we have to do? We have to do resolve this interval into 10 equal parts. So our number start from 4.0, the next value will be 4.1, 4.2, 4.3, 4.4, 4.5, 4.6, 4.7, 4.8, 4.9, then 5.0. It means we represent our first number. This is first. Now we have to locate 4.2. Where it is? 4.2. Here it is. It means we have to circle them and take its next value also. Now we get another interval and we divide this interval again into 10 equal parts. Then we again draw a number line. Our first value is 4.2 and last value is 4.3. We can add 0. So this becomes 4.20. Next one is your 4.21, 4.22, 4.23, 4.24, 4.25, 4.26, 4.27, 4.28, 4.29. But we have resolved this interval into 10 equal parts. Or we have located our first two digit number. Then we have to locate our next digit also. Now this number becomes 4.26. Where it is? 4.26 here. So make a circle and take its next value also. This one is your next value. So this is your interval. Now we have to divide into further 10 equal parts. Then again draw a number line. Our first digit is 4.26, and last one is 4.27, and we can add 0 at the last. So this becomes 4.260. Next one is 4.261. Next one is 4.262. Next one is 4.263. 4.264, 4.265, 4.266, 4.267, 4.268, 4.269, and this becomes 4.27. Then we get our 4 digit. Now we have to find out 4.262. Where it is? 4.262. Here it is. And take your next value. This one is your last value. In this manner, as we know, this number is continuously non-terminating but repeating. So we have to follow its either 2 digit or we have to follow its 6 digit. Either we have to represent it on 4.26, where we get this. You can stop at this level and get the answer this. If you want to do one more step, then you have to follow next step also. Now this one is your 4.262. This is, and you have to divide it into further 10 equal parts. Then mark value is 2.2626. I think this will come on this position, 4.2626... This is the representation of a real number on a number line axis. Please make a note first. Now we are going to discuss some more important problem or important properties related to your rational number as well as irrational number. So I write some basic properties. I discuss it one by one. Firstly, only for your rational number, we already discussed in class 8 the basic properties of rational number. First one is your commutative property. If the order of the element is changed, the result will not be changed. That property is called your commutative property. Second property is your associative. If we have three elements, if we have three rational number and we have to add them, so their position doesn't matter. We have any two. Firstly step add, then we have take the sum as a third addition. Again I repeat, whenever we have three elements and we have to add them, in that case we have to add first two number, then we add the result with the third number, or it's your choice. We can add last two digit two number and then result will be added to your first number. Answer will be same. Third one is your distributive property. Distributive property means we can distribute so any number with the sum of your two numbers. I explain, please make a look. Your commutative property. Commutative property say if we add A plus B or is equal to B plus A, result will be same. Example, if I add 2 plus 3 or 3 plus 2, result will be same because 2 plus 3 is equal to 5, 3 plus 2 is equal to 5. It means if we change the order, the addition will not be changed. Result will always be same. This property is called commutative property. And rational number follow commutative property. But the question arises, is irrational number are also follow the these properties? So this is your third important thing. If we add, subtract, multiply, divide two irrational number, the result may be rational or irrational. What we have talking about, if addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, if we add two numbers which are rational number, then the result will also be a rational number. If we have two numbers and we have to subtract them, then we get another number which is also a rational number. It means the basic property is if we use addition, multiplication, division, subtraction among two rational numbers, then their result after addition, multiplication, division will be a rational number. Again I repeat that addition, subtraction, multiplication, division of a rational number gives the result rational number. But if we apply addition, subtraction, multiplication, division on irrational number, then result may be a rational number or irrational, both. It's not necessarily it may be irrational number, it may be rational as well as irrational. So we are not confirmed, it depends on the question. So this is the basic difference of the first property of rational number and irrational number. If we addition, if we add, subtract, multiply, divide of two irrational number, we get an irrational number. If we apply on rational number, then we get always a rational number. So keep in mind, if we add, subtract, multiply, divide two irrational number, the result may be rational or irrational. But in the case of rational number, it will be always rational number. Please keep in mind. This is your first property, commutative property. So it follows the commutative property as well as it follows the commutative property, both as well as rational number as well as irrational number. Please make a note first. Now our second property is associative. Suppose if we have three elements A plus B plus C. Firstly we have to add A plus B, then we get a result, and that result will add to third number. The same result will be obtained if we add firstly B plus C and then add this result with the this number. Answer will be same. Example, 2 plus 3 plus 4. If we add first these two numbers, 2 plus 3 is equal to 5 and 5 plus 4 is equal to 9. Here we add first two numbers, then add the result obtained after addition of two numbers with the third number. Now 2 plus 3 plus 4. In this case, firstly we have add 3 plus 4, which is equal to 7. Now 7 result will add to first number, we get 9. It means result also will be same. This property is called associative property. Rational number as well as irrational number both follow this property. Please make a look. Our third property is distributive property. For example, if we have to distribute A among the sum of between B plus C, the result will be same as A into B plus B into C. This property is called distributive property. We have distribute. For example, 2 multiplied 3 plus 5. 2 into 3 plus 5 is equal to 8. 8 into 2, 16. Here A is 2, B is 3, B is 3, and C is 5. 2 into 3, 4, sorry, A is 2, B is 3, B is 3, and C is 5. 5 plus 3, 8, and 8 to the 16. 2 into 3, please wait, please make a change. A into B, AB. A into C, AC, not BC. Here is AC. A is 2, B is 3, A is 2, and C is 5. 2 into 3, 6, and 2 into 5, 10. We get 16. So this is your distributive property. So rational number as well as irrational number, both numbers follow commutative property, associative property, and distributive property. So please make a note first. So we already discussed this property, but I take some example which demonstrate such type of property. As we already discussed, rational number, if we add or subtract, multiply, divide with rational number, we get an irrational number. But in that case of irrational number, the result may be rational or irrational. Let's take a look. For example, if I take a rational number root 2, root 2 is your irrational number, which has a value 1.14415. This one is your irrational number. It's non-terminating. It means it never be terminated. We have to know its starting point, but we don't have its end point. That number is called irrational numbers. Again, I repeat, irrational number are those numbers which are non-terminating and not repeating. That numbers are irrational numbers. So root 2 is an irrational number. is suppose I add root 5. Root 5 is also an irrational number which has value 2.3132, like values. It's also non-terminating, not repeating. Now if we add them, root 2 plus root 5, which is a irrational number. If we add them, because we cannot find its end point, so whatever digits that we have to just simply add them. 2 and 5, 7, 3 and 1, 4, 1 and 4, 5, 3 and 1, 4, 0.2113. This one is your irrational number. So in this case, if we add two irrational numbers, we get an irrational number. Now I take another example. Please make a look first. Now I am taking root 5 is our irrational number. Second one number is negative root 5. We have to add them. Root 5 plus minus root 5, and we know plus minus is minus root 5 root 5, which is equal to 0. Again, we have to add, first number is root 5 and second number is minus square root of 5. If we add them, root 5 plus minus root 5, and we know plus minus is minus, root 5 cancel out with root 5, we get 0, and 0 is your rational number. 0 is your rational number. It means in first case, if we add two irrational numbers, we get an irrational number. But in this case, we add two irrational numbers, but we get a rational number. So in the irrational number, for the irrational number, there is not always the addition, multiplication, division may be a rational number or may be a irrational number. Let's take another example of multiplication. Please make a look first. Now I am going to take an example of division. Question is, divide square root of 6 by square root of 2. We have to divide square root of 6 by square root of 2, then what will be the result? Square root of 6 divided by square root of 2. If in the numerator the term is in square root, as well as the denominator is also in square root, so we can take the number as a whole square root. So in this we take the number 6 by 2 and making whole square root, which is equal to 2, 3 is a 6, we get 3, and root 3 is a irrational number. Now I take its reverse example. You have to divide root 5 by or 2 root 5 by root 5. Question is, you have to divide 2 square root of 5 by square root of 5. Then what will be the answer? 2 into square root of 5 divided by square root of 5. Square root of 5, square root of 5 cancel out. we get a number is 2, and 2 is a rational number. So this property, I hope this will be clear to you. The addition, subtraction, multiplication, division of two irrational number may or may not be rational or irrational. It may be rational or irrational. So please make a note. I hope this property will be clear to you. Now we come on our next property. This property is the sum or the difference of rational number and irrational number. In previous case, we deals with either rational number or irrational number separately. But in this case, if we take one number as a rational number and one number as a irrational number, then what will be the result after addition or multiplication, division and so on? The result will be a irrational always. Please make a note. Example, addition 2 and root 3. If we add 2 plus root 3, you know 2 is your rational number and root 3 is your irrational number. If we add them, we get an irrational number. 2 plus, and we know what will be the value? 3.173 and so on. If we add them, 2 plus 3 is equal to 5.173, which one is your irrational number. This property apply on addition, subtraction, multiplication, division in all the case. Please make a note and keep in mind, because this property not will help in your 9th class, but it will help in your 10th class, 11th class and 12th class, and even your higher class, because this concept will becomes wide in higher class. So please make a note first. Now we take our second property, the product or the quotient. Quotient means division. If we have applied the property product or division of a non-zero, it means the number rational or the number is rational number, never equal to zero, because if we divide the number by zero, we get the undefined number. If we take irrational number divided by rational number, and irrational number suppose is root 3, let, and rational number is 0, because 0 is rational number. If we divide it, we get undefined number. Again, I repeat that if we apply the rules, product or the quotient of non-zero rational number, we are use the language non-zero. Non-zero means the number never be equal to zero, because this zero makes the result undefined. For example, if we use division of irrational number and rational number, let us consider our irrational number is root 3, because I have known and you also know root 3 is your irrational number. If we divide it by 0 and 0 is your rational number, if any number is divided by 0, you will get undefined number. So that's why we cannot take 0 as one of the number. The result will be a irrational number. How the result will be irrational number? Please look. This is your example 1. Now I take example 2. Here this is your rational number and this one is your irrational number, because 2 is your rational number and pi has value 3.1415 and so on. Non terminating, non repeating. So pi is also your irrational number and 2 is your rational number. Who multiply? If we multiply 2 with pi, 2 is your rational number but pi is your irrational number. If we multiply them, 2 multiply pi, pi has value 3.1415. What we will get? We get 6.28, or 2 5s are 10, 2 30, 8 2 6, 6.28, but continuously, non terminating, but and also digits are not repeating. So number is your irrational. So this property said if you use product or quotient and with only non-zero, then result will always be irrational. The result always be irrational. I hope this will be clear to you. Please make a note. Now we are going to remember some important property which is applied on the square root function. Some important results on square root function. If we have found terms in square root and apply the operation like addition, multiplication, division, and so on, so these results will help you to solve their terms and get the simplified result. What are their properties? I will take each and every question with example. First property is your, if your A, B, C, D, it means A, B, C, D, whatever we use, variables A, B, C, D, all are your positive. Please keep in mind, square root function gives always a positive number. Or you not? Square root function must be positive. It is necessary. Whatever the terms in the square root, it must be positive, because square root of negative function cannot be calculated. Square root function never be negative. That's why A, B, all A, B, C are positive, not negative. We cannot take its value negative, because if we take its value negative, it makes its complex, which you will study in your higher level in class 11th or 12th. So keep in mind, square root function always be positive real value function. So first result is, if two variables are multiplied in a common root, then we can separate them by making each square root individual, and the sign of multiplication will be same. For example, if I have a square root 3 and I can write 6 in terms of its factor, 2 into 3, so I can separate them, square root of 2 multiply square root of 3, or vice versa. If the result is given in this form, you can take a single square root and the value will be multiplied. For example, if here is x, here is 2. Now we have two square root function having multiplier. So we can take a single square root and make the multiplier. X into 2, which is 2x. This one is your first property. If two variables multiply or two values multiply into a single square root, we can separate them by taking each individual square root. Please make a note. Now we will discuss our next property, square root of a quotient term. It means any terms in terms of numerator and denominator. We can take square root of individual numerator as well as denominator, or we can take its vice versa also. For example, if I have 21 divided by 5, we can write in terms of 21 divided by root 5. We can take separate square root of numerator as well as denominator. Reciprocal is also true. For example, if I have 12, this one is your 3. So we can make a single square root, 12 divided by 3. Now 3 will cancel out, 12, 4, what we will get? 4, and square root of 4 is 2. This will be your answer. Such property will help you to simplify the complex expression. So you must be keeping your mind. Please make a note. So now we are taking our next property, square root of two function, which are in terms of a plus b, and next one is a minus b. The result is a minus b. How it is? Because it is simply just like matching your identity. A square minus b square, which is equal to a minus b, a plus b in similar manner. For example, in this I have square root of 3 minus square root of 2. Square root of 3 plus square root of 2. Here a is 3 and b is 2. One is your positive and next one is your negative. Simply match a minus b, a minus b, because terms are same. In this a minus b and this one is a plus b, what will be the formula? Square of both of them with sign negative. So first a is your root 3, we have to do square. So square negative, second term is your root b, square root of 2, and square root will be cancelled if we do square. So square root will be cancelled with 2. We get 3. Here we get 2. 3 minus 2 is equal to 1. That will be your final answer. Please make a note. Now your next property is a plus square root. It means one number is in terms of direct and second number is your square root. Then this property is similar to as first. How it is? Please look. Example 2, 3 plus square root of 2, 3 minus square root of 2. Here 3 is given directly, but 2 is given in terms of square root function. Now but the term is a plus b and a minus b. Apply the property. Identity is a minus b into a plus b, which is equal to a square minus b square. Here a is your 3, b is your root. Again a match with 3 and b match with root 2. One is plus and one is minus. Square root of 3 is 9. and square root will be cancelled out with the square function. So root is cancelled out with 2. We will get 2. 9 minus 2 is equal to 7. This is your answer. So this identity is very important. Please keep in mind every time. Please make a note. Now our next property is, if we have to multiply this, all these square root of different number, then what will be the result and how we multiply? For example, this is your root 2, root 3, root 5, root 7. We have to multiply this. Firstly, root 2 is multiplied by root 5. Root 2 multiplied with root 5 plus. Now root 2 is multiplied with root 7. Root 2 is multiplied with root 7. Now plus. Now this root 3 is multiplied with root 5. Root 3 multiplied root 5. Now this root 3 is multiplied root 7. Root 3 multiplied root 7. As our first property, if two numbers are multiplied in square root function, then we take a single square root. So in this we take a single square root. Number is multiplied, 2 into 5, 10, plus single square root, 2 into 7, 14, plus single square root, 3 into 5, 15, plus 3 into 7, 21. That will be the result. Please make a note. Now our next property is square root of e plus square root of b, and the whole square, what will be its value? It is simple, as we have already discussed in class 8, a plus b whole square. We know the identity. A plus b whole square is equal to a square plus b square plus 2ab. Suppose here is root 2 plus root 3 whole square. Firstly, we have to do square of first number, which is equal to root 2 square. Second number is your root 3. Do square root of root 3. Then plus 2 into your first number is root 2, but second number is root 3. And we know, if we do square of a square root function, then square root function will be cancelled out. Then we get 2. Here is also square root function will cancel out with scaling. We get 3 plus 2. And these are two square root functions which are multiplied. So we get a single square root. 2 into 3, 6. 2 plus 3, which is equal to 5, plus 2 square root of 6. That will be your final answer. So please make a note, and I again request you, if you like my video, so do subscribe my channel by click on the given YouTube button. So for this you get automatically new updation notification whenever I post a new video. Again I request, whenever I post a new video for your class, you will get an automatically a notification. So there is no need to continuously note on my channel to see watch my channels, because you will get a notification. So please, if you like my video, so do subscribe my channel. Then we will meet our next video. Thank you for watching my sub video.